This is Duke University.
Duke researchers have found what they call quantum jitters in the shapes of DNA bases that may account for the spontaneous mutations driving both evolution and disease.
So in the 1950s, when Watson and Crick solved the structure of the DNA duplex, they hypothesized that the DNA bases themselves can spontaneously undergo a transformation to a state that would allow mispairs. So when the enzymes that copy DNA encounter base pairs that aren't correctly matched, they have mechanisms of detecting this and kicking out the mismatched pairs. We've discovered essentially what Watson and Crick hypothesized, that the bases in a DNA duplex can undergo these transitions to these very rare and very fleeting states that allow mispairs to adopt a geometry that looks like a normal Watson and Crick pair, but is not a normal Watson and Crick pair. So we use a sophisticated method called nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy, and through a whole bunch of interesting experiments, we were able to tease out all these details using chemical modification, mutations, and quantum simulations. The normal state of these mispairs jumps to these Watson and Crick-like states through a dance of protons and changing of bonds. These states are exceedingly rare, and they exist for just microseconds, and they have populations of less than 1%, so 0.17 to 0.008%.
The Duke team found that the mispairs could happen at a rate of 1 in 1,000 to 1 in 100,000 base pair duplications. That error rate closely matches experimental evidence for how often spelling mistakes occur in DNA duplication.
Produced by Duke University.